still on the screen on it. Okay, reasons for designation. This is an example of an Art Deco-like railroad bridge. I believe to be the last intact Pacific Electric Bridge remaining in Los Angeles, and I'm going to state intact in that even though it doesn't have the tracks anymore, all the other attributes of the bridge still exist. Pacific Electric Railway was a major factor in the growth of Southern California during the first half of the 20th century. Only a handful of Pacific Electric-related properties have been recognized as the city of Los Angeles' historic cultural monuments. And this is also significant. The history of Pacific Electric in Los Angeles is a critical part of the growth, especially during the 1920s, during the wars, and even before the wars, where the Pacific Electric lines were run out two areas in order for development to follow that. As the automobile began to displace the trains later on in the mid part of the century, the PD began to, its influence began to wane, but during the early part of the century especially, this was a major part of the development process of the area. It's also to note the only change in the conversion to auto traffic in 1951 was the short line track, which went on Huntington Drive, was abandoned by the PD. This is the intersection prior to the bridge being built. It was considered to be a very dangerous intersection in that you had four train tracks crossing where you had two different roads, or actually three different roads coming together. This is where Mission Road actually comes here and Huntington Drive begins, and you also have Soto Street coming to the same location. And you have Huntington Drive North and Huntington Drive South. So there was a very odd configuration here, and it was considered a very dangerous one. I don't have stats on accidents, I know there were some that occurred there between trains and cars. As a result of this situation, the bridge was actually built as a mitigation to solve that problem. Here's a Los Angeles Times article that states the need for the bridge, shows the design of the bridge. And I want to note specifically the design of this bridge because it has not changed. You see the two concrete wings of the bridge and then the center section, which is made of steel. And the bridge is exactly today as it was when it was first designed. Here's a picture of the bridge when it was first built. You can see a PD car on it. And again, you see the, and just as the rendering showed, you see the three sections of the bridge. Today, this is a satellite view. You can't really see it that well, but if you look, you can see again the steel portion on the left and then the concrete, or the steel portion in the center of the concrete. It's kind of hard to see in this picture. Here is an early picture of the bridge when it was first opened. And here is a similar shot today. It shows the, I can go back and forth on this because if you'll look, you'll see the pylons and other attributes of the bridge. I also want to note the catenary poles that are alongside the bridge because those catenary poles actually still exist. They were converted to light fixtures. So they're still there. So, I mean, there's a lot of original fabric in this bridge still intact. Here's another view of the bridge looking from Huntington, and I want to note the walkway. This is, there was a station up there where people could go on the train, and note the railing as well. Here we have the same steps, same railing in existence today. Again, very little change. Here's another view of the bridge that was taken during the day. And this is one of the arguments that they've been making about the bridge does not have enough clearance for truck traffic. The interesting thing is when it was built, it did have enough clearance for truck traffic. The situation was that over the years, the roads were repaved and repaved. And the result was the road bed raised up to a point where they no longer have the proper clearance for trucks. And our argument is, why not just shave the road back down to the original level and you will have clearance again. Here's a similar view today. You know, the several pylon and the catenary wires that are now bugs. Here's some of the details of the bridge. Underneath section, again, none of this has changed. Here's the steps on the other side of the bridge for the outgoing traffic. The other one was for the traffic going in toward Los Angeles. This is for the traffic going outside Los Angeles. Again, the piping, original fixture. Here's a close-up of it. And again, some of the Art Deco The bridge was originally was converted to traffic, a four-lane bridge with echo of the four tracks. One of the arguments being made today is that it's inadequate. Well, it was shrunk down to two lanes at some point in recent history, and that may be one of the reasons. But today, that bridge does serve a purpose, and it allows traffic to flow much better at this intersection than it would if it was a bunch of signals at a three-street intersection. Again, similar views. I see an early view, early color view of the train leading up toward the bridge. I notice Soto Street is on the right there, and then the trains are on the left. Again, a shot of the center steel section of the bridge. Underneath the steel section, notice that the bridge is back in. What's interesting is I mentioned there were only seven out of over 1,050 historic cultural monuments that were related to the Pacific Electric Railway. Only one is for a bridge, and that is to the abutments of a demolished bridge. The watch station, which was used by the PD, the Pacific Electric building, which was the headquarters of the Pacific Electric, the subway terminal building, which is where the subway that extended out to the Toluca Tunnel and all extended out to the Ivy substation. I'm sorry, I don't have a more recent picture of the restored building, which was a power substation for the Pacific Electric. You have the Pacific Electric Big Old Railway Station, which unfortunately was destroyed by fire about 20 years ago, so it's no longer with us. These are the red car trestle footings at Fletcher Drive in Glendale. Fletcher Drive in Riverside. This is the one bridge-related monument that we have. Then you have the Dalmont Tunnel and Toluca Station over in the Crown Hill area, which is where the tunnel actually came out that extended on that bridge. The buttons we saw was actually an extension of the line that came through the tunnel the subway. And so now we look at this bridge. We have an existing bridge. And we are asking that this bridge be looked upon as a very important part of the Pacific Electric. I think it's the only bridge left that was purely used by the PE during its day. And it's still a usable bridge today. It's still intact. There's no argument that this bridge has seismic issues. It may need to pass some retrofitting, especially with some of the new rules that are coming down. But I believe this retrofitting can be done. It is a very important part of El Sereno, which is really an underrepresented community, too. We only have one cultural monument, and that was one that was returned last year. And again, there's another historic view of the bridge. Current view showing a similar view of the bridge. Here it is in 1951 when it was converted to auto traffic. And we're asking you please vote to place Pacific Electric Soto Street Bridge full name under consideration of the Los Angeles Cultural Monument. Thank you.